important.
I mean, okay, so there are different, let's say, different thoughts about this, you know, or different kind of like thoughts led to the idea to work with a team or with an idea, with a concept. One is mainly this, that I am, you know, that I am somebody, you know, when I drive around, or when I'm on a trip or whatever, you know, I see here something or there something that I like, I see something in the TV that I like, in a magazine, in a book, you know, like, so I constantly change a little bit what I like, you know. Now, of course, I have generally, you know, like a taste, you know, like with what I go with my intuition, you know. But the problem is when you always change, you know, like, let's say when you work out of your belly, you know, I consider to work out of your belly, you know, like with your instinct, when you mainly work like this, you somehow get very insecure if you have different influences, you know, like one day I like this, next day I like this. So I like, you know, like if I can follow a certain thing. And the more I have, the less I have an idea, you know, to work with a house, the more I'm insecure. Like I tend to change it constantly. That's why I once, you know, like probably 10, 15 years, you know, when I started to make architecture, I started to work with this idea to have an idea to work with. And that means it's like, you can like compare it with a writer, that when a writer writes an essay or writes a book or whatever, let's say an essay, this writer does not start to put down words or whatever, you know, like this writer starts to think what his story will be about, you know. And the story has to be quite defined before you can start to write, and it's the same with the architecture. I think it's, for me, it's very important to continue at least for one project with a certain idea, you know, and not leave it again.
So is it for every project there is a new idea, or is there a more general idea for you that is behind you being an architect?
Yeah, of course, every project is based on a new idea. There are sometimes certain motifs, you know, certain aspects of an idea that I like or that I could not build in before, you know, that I start, that I continue to think about, or that kind of flows in a new project. But let's say you are asking me now about, you know, what is kind of my philosophical background also, you know, let's say what is the common, you know, like idea of everything. And the common idea is this, and it's this idea of making also an object or an architecture that is made that reacts or that acts like one thing. You know, that's not like one idea, one thing. And this is what I call an organism, you know, like an organism where all the parts in an organism, you know, like are dependent on each other and kind of grow out of each other into a next, you know, like kind of part of the whole of the whole thing, you know. And this is what I like also about architecture. I'm not talking about the tectonic, of course, you know, the tectonic, you know, like you can also talk about the tectonic in a plant, you know, or so. No, I'm talking more about this one thing, you know, like everything. You know, like when you take a piece away, it does not fit anymore. And it's not when you take a piece away that it does not look anymore, that it's not good anymore or so. I really want to make buildings when you take a piece away, then they break apart, you know. And for this, for example, concrete is a very ideal material because you pour it. Concrete you can use on traction, you can use it on pressure. I'm talking about reinforced concrete, you know. And with concrete you can do everything. You can make a plate, you can make a stick, you can make a wall, you can make a roundish wall, you can make a cupola, you know, like you can make vaulted ceilings. You can make everything in concrete, you just pour it, you know. And it's like, it's used on traction and pressure. And with this I can go the most, you know, like I can work the most on this idea, or it's the best material to work on this idea of making one thing.
It intrigues me a lot that you want to build something that is a whole, that is a unity, and if you take one part away, then basically it doesn't function anymore. It's not good anymore, or it's not perceived anymore.
Or it breaks apart.
I'm wondering. Why where that fascination is coming from? Why you have that fascination? Because I can imagine that it might be a kind of reaction to.
I think it's more total. It's just more total. Yeah. Let's say, look, it's also like this. When you say that your thing, that your object or your architecture is one thing, then the consequence of this is also that. That you are not a composer, you are a divider, I would say. I mean, these are two expressions that we can use. A composer is one that puts things together in a modular way, you know. That means at the end, you know, like the organism that is created, or let's say the settlement that is created by an architect is a composer, has different heights, you know, like it's like it sticks, something sticks out here or there, you know, like up and down, you know, like it doesn't have a clear form from outside, or it doesn't have a defined form. It's kind of like the internal need of like composing leads to forms that are not one thing.
Yeah.
And when you do one thing, you have one idea, and you want to do one thing, then you divide it up.
Mm-hmm.
So the consequence is also that I always work with a square or with a cube. You know, like, of course, I don't believe in the square or the cube as almost religious, you know, like idea, you know, like whatever. But it's just like, it's the more you think about something and the more you are this divider, you know, the more you cannot, you start with like an absolute form. And the absolute form would be a ball or a sphere or would be a cube or a square or whatever, you know. And this is how I also, it's more, to work with one thing and to be a divider, it's just the fascination of being more total, of being more clean, you know, of being cleaner, of being more like a human brain than to be an animal. You know, like the thing originally also came, you know, that I work with a concept or with one idea or one thing, also came out of. I had a father, you know, like a strong architect, a strong personality, you know, and somehow I had to survive when I was young, you know, like I also chose this profession. And if I would just work out of my belly, out of my instinct, I would end up somewhere with the same genetic program, like with my father. I would kind of like make what my father did, and I wanted to make something different. So I had to first, you know, like kind of give up my own past. I had to destroy my past, more or less. And you cannot destroy your past with instinct. You have this. You can only do with brain. And then it's typical psychoanalysis. You do it with your brain, you know. So first of all, I cleaned up and I emptied my backpack, you know, whatever. And then I had to start again. And if there is nothing anymore left, I talk now very much with teachers. If there's nothing left, you have to invent it. And when you invent, basically, as you start to invent, you end up with an idea, you know.
Yeah.
So you start from zero, you know. And then that's how I did, how I started with this. And I found out that it really helps me, and it kind of, it also brings me, you know, like I don't have to always question myself if this is what I do is right or wrong, you know, generally, philosophically. Like, is it socially right, is it politically right, is it ethically right or whatever. I just do what I do because I have an idea and I just, I'm a craftsman, you know, that helps executing the idea that I made up, of course. But then I can say it's the right form that is like that comes out that my idea generates, or is it the wrong form or whatever. So like this, it's kind of a logic. Of course, it's not always very logic, but it's a logic way of doing things.